was the best of times.
It was the worst of times.
It was the best. It was the best. It was the best of times.
It was the worst of times.
It was the best.
You stupid monkey.
Put No Man's Sky, Portal and Mirror's Edge into a meat grinder, added in a heavy helping of satire, and hit max power, you'd come up with something close to the surprisingly addictive experience that is Journey to the Savage Planet. It's a game full of rich colours, good humour, and genuinely captivating exploration that'll have you rocket jumping, alien goop devouring, and creature punting your way into the early hours of the morning. Trying to provide a simple description for this game is almost too difficult to put into words.
It looks kind of like a building-sized death meatball. I mean, who knows what it is or what horrors it contains.
Savage Planet isn't one specific thing. It's a satisfying combination of so many fantastical game elements that it feels like it'll almost drown under the weight of the expectations. However, hours into the campaign, and you'll still be working on that next upgrade to gain access to an area that's just beyond your reach. It's equal parts platformer, puzzle solving, FPS, and parkour, which becomes a healthy melange of awesome experiences. Your character is essentially an astronaut-shaped pile of meat shot out into space on a speculative mission by your employer, Kindred Aerospace, the fourth best interstellar exploration company. Crash landing on planet ARY-26, you're tasked with surveying the planet as a potential new home for humanity, while scavenging supplies to repair and refuel your ship for the journey home. The planet was supposed to be devoid of all intelligent life, although it becomes immediately apparent that there are larger things at work here. And here your journey really begins, setting out as an explorer of an alien planet with the vaguest of instructions. You'll start out squashing puffer birds for carbon elements, and you'll end the game dodging pike manders with ease. The variety of creatures in the world is as diverse and interesting as the plant life. You'll need to scan each individual one to find out what makes them tick, which you'll need to learn to turn them into harmless piles of goop. The combat elements of this game are fun, and for the most part take a backseat to the exploration of the world, although occasionally they are part of the puzzle itself, which you'll need to unlock to progress to that next area. There is an interesting inventory management system here, where you'll need to collect resources from flora and fauna of the planet to work towards upgrading your gear. With the help of your ship's 3D printer, you'll be able to jump higher and shoot for longer to solve the previously unsolvable puzzles. Initially, you'll find yourself reaching areas which are impossible to pass, and all that means is that you have to work a little bit harder at being the best space explorer to progress past them. Upgrading equipment is tied to your rating as an explorer. By finishing up a series of very specific activities, such as collecting samples from progressively aggressive animals, you'll gain points towards your explorer rating. Finish the tasks, and you're rewarded with the next tier of gear. Fair warning though, the first level of explorer is easy to obtain, anything further is exceptionally difficult. Although the great part about this game is that you can finish it with nearly none of the extra upgrades beyond what you need to defeat the biome bosses. While it's possible to do the bare minimum to pass, the real magic of the game is in discovering all of the extra secrets that you can unlock if you really explore and experiment. Once you've finally upgraded your equipment, you'll be triple jumping around and laser grappling onto ledges to unlock secrets like some sort of spaceman Indiana Jones, which is technically a Flash Gordon, but that would be an incredibly dated reference that we wouldn't dare to admit knowing in this review. Savage Planet is a game that really knows what it's all about. You'll see ads within the world for imaginary products which are at first seem too silly to be real. Fans of the satirical genius Paul Verhoeven will find their home in this game, with sparkling laugh-out-loud humour which instantly reminds you of the advertising in Robocop or Starship Troopers. Red alert, red alert, red alert.
Lord.
You crossed my line of death.
You haven't dismantled your MX stockpile.
Pakistan is threatening my border.
That's it, Buster. No more military aid.
Nuke 'em. Get them before they get you. Another quality home game from Butler Brothers.
Wedgie Burger.
Remember me? You said I'd never be back. Well, guess who's back? Wedgie Burger's back open. Health violations no longer a problem. They tried to shut me down. They couldn't take me out. They wanted me to shut up. You can't stop the wedge. Wedgie Burger, come down. Get some potato wedges. Bring the kids. Get right the wedge later. Mom's eating for free, okay?
It's five delicious vegan patties between two homemade buns. Boiled twice, so it's extra chewy with ketchup, cheese, and fun.
Delicious!
The new five-patty vegan boil burger is fun for the whole family. And made with 100% stuck-up, free-range vegans.
Burgers may cause irritable bowel, partial blindness, itchy ears, tongue warts, involuntary liver convulsions, loss of appetite. Wedgie Burger's not responsible for any medical problems arising from digestive system failure.
What are you looking at, you sick perv?
Wedgie Burger!
It's slightly whimsical, slightly self-deprecating, and slightly scary in how accurate this could all potentially be. Where most games make this content dry and inaccessible for your average player, Savage Planet leans into it and makes it essential viewing, which provides the game with its voice and personality. If there's one knock on this game, it's that it's relatively short experience. 12 to 15 hours will get you completely finished cover to cover. There's even a trophy in place for anyone finishing the game in under 4 hours. We'll be waiting with bated breath for the inevitable speedrunning videos on YouTube where someone finishes the game in like 15 minutes. Now, game developer Typhoon have promised much more to come in the future, and the way that the individual biomes have been set up means there's abundant opportunities for that expansion. Journey to the Savage Planet is an intoxicating experience, which is more than worth the price of admission. It's charming, hilarious, and an all-round fun experience that will have you smiling and laughing no matter what age you are. Typhoon should really continue to support and develop this experience to solidify its place as an early and incredibly strong contender for Best Indie Game of 2020. There is but one mystery that had us scratching our heads at the end of this game. Who the heck is Scott Norwood? If you find out, let us know. For more on Journey to the Savage Planet and other games, check out Shaker Not New on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, or subscribe now at your nearest podcatcher.
You're unflattered. Maybe even a little curious.
He wouldn't even hear me.